I, Edward Cullen, take you, Bella Swan.
For better or for worse.
To love.
To cherish. As long as we both shall live.
It's the moment Twilight fans have been waiting for. Breaking Dawn, Part 1. Is in theaters right now. The film marks the beginning of the end of the hit series. And this morning, our own Gino Salamone sits down with one of its stars, Robert Pattinson. It's a one-on-one interview that you'll see only on 12 News.
I love the evolution of the man in this movie because in the grand scheme of things, if I'm married, there's no way I'm allowing her ex to be there at the same time.
This is the one kind of fundamental issue I had with the story. I was like, okay, come on, there's no way to play this without looking like a total nerd. I mean, like, it's like there's a line which is so Jacob just dancing across the line whenever he feels like it. Edward just kind of just takes it. He's a cuckold almost.
I know, and I don't even know what that means, cuckold, but I agree with you.
Sam's lost the element of surprise, and he doesn't want to take you on outnumbered. So he's not going to come at you head on. He's got the place surrounded, and he'll wait for his opportunity.
We won't get through it without a fight.
No fights. We won't be the ones to break the treaty.
The treaty is void, at least in Sam's mind.
Not in ours.
Carlisle, no one's hunted for weeks.
We'll make do.
You've done us a great service, Jacob. Thank you.
A certain, I mean, because Bella is quite an interesting character in that respect as well. Because I think most girls would want, at a certain point, if they've decided that they're going to be with this other guy, I mean, another person keeps consistently trying to chat them up. There has to be a point where the person who they've chosen to be with has to go like, listen, man, like you've got to stop this right now. Like otherwise, it's going to be horrible.
I agree.
And the girl wants to see you do that as well, and so it's kind of interesting that Bella doesn't want to see that.
What is it?
How many days has it been since the wedding?
14, what? Can you tell me what's going on?
I'm late. My period's late.
Moment you knew you were famous, when did it hit? Was there an incident or when you said, oh boy, my life has changed?
Probably, I used to live at this place called the Oakwood Apartments, like in Burbank. And I think, because I'd been sitting, I'd lived there for about 6 months, and I think an Entertainment Weekly or something came out, and this girl came up and she was like, you think no one's going to notice you out here? And I've been sitting by the pool, like I just read scripts there every single day and never thought anything of it. I didn't even know the magazine had come out. And then everyone started acting immediately like, you're trying to hide with your hat and your sunglasses. And I'm like, oh, I'm just wearing a hat and sunglasses. And now I actually do wear it to hide.
Okay, Twihards, we're not done yet. Pattinson also used the opportunity to tell Gino about his false fondness for a certain local sports team.
I have a Milwaukee, I have a Brewers hat. Yeah, I have a multitude of Brewers hats, actually, but I don't know anything about the team. I just like the hat.
It was going so well, and then you said that, but that's okay.
We don't know why he has all the Brewers hats, but Gino also sat down with Pattinson's co-star Kristen Stewart. You can see that one-on-one interview tomorrow on 12 News This Morning, and you can get more of your Twilight fix anytime by heading to WISN.com. That's where you'll find videos, reviews, slideshows, and an interactive section. Just look for the Breaking Dawn link in the Hot Topics section.